significance of these three incredible artists to contemporary Pacific art and to New Zealand art, and also to art education, because all three are not only being visible and making work and pushing and changing through discourse and their work, whole experiences of Vahine's Polynesia, but also, you know, they're in the New Zealand art curriculum.
We sort of thought about a name, and we like the idea of space, and you know, the va, and played on the fact that even though it's a Eastern Polynesian word, that the va is everything. These two, when I met them, they're both in this ala working in a spatial way, and mine is painting, but I think about the va beyond the painting surface. So it was something that the name sort of kept us like thinking about it and talking about it. And really, this is just another conversation having this exhibition.
I got interested in the idea of the man-bird forms, you know, sort of short, sort of steep, I suppose. A lot of cultures and throughout history have associated birds with spiritual, with the spirit, I suppose, partly because they're celestial and they have the mystery of flight, which we don't have. So we tend to think as human beings that when we pass on, well, either you know that you gallop up for some reason into the ether. So, a while ago I did a series for a show here actually called Flock, I think, and that was just basically a whole lot of bird man forms that had gone through pre-contact material culture, so it's all sorts of different things, carvings and, you know, like bird, boat prows and amulets and all sorts of things. Because I found it interesting that this goes like across history and across cultures, across time. Mm. It's a pervasive thing that is common to
human experience. Yeah.
So, and I always find that interesting, trying to anchor, I suppose, myself within some kind of context, and I always look for the common, what's in common. And then with using the found objects, it's to me, objects have a narrative of their own. They have an inbuilt narrative already, so people look at those and they bring their own feelings and emotions and history to bear.
What's really exciting in Auckland at the moment is this is where the Pacific art's really going off at the moment, is Auckland. Especially with our Polynesian visual artists, and probably with the group Faf Swag, who are out there really claiming their space, claiming our space, the community that they're talking about, the gay, transgender, lesbian community. Well, that's my community, you know, and I'm just, you know, it's so good to hear straight people, heterosexuals, actually go along to gigs and go, I was just sitting there going, yeah, 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 you know, because big is beautiful, black is beautiful, big is sexy, you know, like, if you've got it, strut it, you know, and it's so empowering to our people, to all of that generation of youth. I'm really excited at this new generation. Mm. I have to say, it's so good to see curators and writers coming out. Mm. Lana lupe, excellent writer, also looking at really contemporary issues, urban issues. Mm. She's not afraid to put forward her perspective on anything, which is great. Then you've got Ioana Gordon-Smith, you know, curator out at Te Uru. Someone who I've worked with closely a couple of times, great writer. If we look at practitioners, of course they're going to do things a little bit different to how we do things, but I think there is more of an emphasis on what I've seen is graphic design and also on art performance.
And social practice.
Whilst, you know, we have Samoan blood, I'm never going to be a great orator. I mean, I might not even be a great artist, but this is how I prefer to speak. I think that's how we would prefer is this forum is through our art, because we can control it.
Yeah.
It's a var in itself, but it's just a different aspect.
Yes.
So whether it fits in with customary, it's just in this context, in this space, in this country, speaking to other people that are like us and not like us, we are having our say, I suppose.